Apyayantu mamangani Om Sahana Bhavatu Sahana Bhunaktu Sahaviryam Karavavahe Tejasvinavadhitamastu Mavidvishavahe Om Shanti 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 Apyayantu mangani Vak pranas chakshu shrotram atho badam indriyani sarvani Sarva brahma upanishadam Maham brahma niraguryam Maham maham brahma nirakarovat Anirakaranam astavadikaranam mesastu Tadātmani nirateya upanishata shuru dharmahate te mai santu Om Shanti Shanti Shanti
The first section of sixth chapter of Chandogya connected the disciple son Svetaketu with father Uddalaka who became teacher. And father asked him the question, what is that by knowing which unheard becomes heard, unthought of becomes thought of, unknown becomes known. Do you know that?
Yes.
So our answer can be yes, but Svetaketu said
no.
He said no. And therefore, father began the teaching. So the purpose of Vedanta study, Brahma Vidya, is to know my infinitude. And by knowing my infinitude, I bring an end to all my problems. Because all my problems are due to ideas of limitations. So the teacher starts teaching by saying, Sadeva Somya Idamagra Asi Ekameva Advitiyam. That one alone without the second is there at the origin of creation. And from that sat, due to Ikshanam, the word Ikshanam presented Chaitanya aspect. Sahikshata Bahusyam Prajaye Iti. So Ikshanam means it is also of the nature of consciousness. So it is Sat, it is Chit, and it is Ekameva Advitiyam means infinite. So it is Sat Swarupa, it is Chit Swarupa, and it is Ananta. The Ikshanam of Sat resulted in Tejaha, fire. Then Ikshanam of Tejaha brought in Apaha, waters. And its Ikshanam brought Annam, earth and all food. So in this way, the creation process was briefly explained and it was said, the entire creation, Jagat, and Jiva, our gross body and subtle body, everything consists of Teja, Ab, Annam, fire, water, earth, and these three are nothing but Sat. Therefore, everything in this creation is Sat. So Sat is material cause and Sat also is efficient cause, because it alone is Chaitanya. So Abhinna, Nimitta, Upadana, Karanam. these phrases, they are technical phrases. You can note them, eventually you will know them. So from that, existence, consciousness, infinitude, the entire universe has come, all bodies are formed, our mind is annamayam, annamayam hi somya manaha, apomaya pranaha, tejomai vak. This is what teacher said. Then teacher explained that this sat alone is nothing but your true nature. And for that, he gave different ideas, different examples. First, he said that when we go to sleep, we all merge in sat. That sat, where we all go, that I am. That sat, which constitutes our body because of hunger and thirst, that sat from which all bodies have come, by which all bodies are supported, that into which all bodies merge. Sanmulaha imaha sarvaha prajaha sat ayatanaha sat pratishthaha. That sat you are. In other words, I should not have my own idea of sat. What is sat? That is very well defined in Upanishads. So I should not remain vague about my true nature. This is why there is thorough study. So teacher talked about this. And then he is saying, that sat you are. Then the question came, if we are going to sat every day in night or daytime also, then why we don't know? So it is just like, he gave the example, the honeybees, when they gather honey from different places, that honey does not know from which source I have come or where I am now, because everything is one. So sati sampadya na viduhu sati sampadyamahe, and satah agachha na viduhu satah agachhamahe. So having come from sat, satah agatya na viduhu satah agachhamahe. So I do not know my dissolution place as sat, I don't know my origin place as sat. So the honeybee and the reverse example, two examples were taken in section 9 and 10, correct?
Yes.
Then 11th section talked about the tree. If it is cut, if it is alive, the sap will come. In other words, every living entity has jiva expressing through it. That jiva does not die when the equipments die. So through that 11th section, the continuity of jiva across the bodies and also from one creation to another creation, jiva is going to continue. And this jiva will follow karma siddhanta. So that there is no discrepancy in how should I account for my joys and sorrows in life. They are tied to my karmas. That sat, in which all jivas get dissolved at the time of pralaya, from which all jivas will come out at the time of creation, that sat, O Svetaketu, you are. Then in section 12, What did teacher say? He said, you bring lavanam, right? The salt example came, or the dhana example, which one? No.
Salt.
The dhana. Nyagrodha phalam. So he said, how from the subtle sat, gross universe can come, it is just like from the subtlest part of the seed, the giant tree can come out. So, sukshma karanam can produce sthula karyam. And if we ask the question, but I don't see that, I don't see anything. So, it is said to know that you have to use the right means of knowledge. You cannot use wrong means of knowledge. And for that, he gave the example of putting salt in water. So if I try to look through my eyes, the dissolved salt, I cannot know. If I put my hand, I cannot find. But only if I taste, I will know. In the same way, if I want to know Brahman, is this creation alone is nothing but Brahman, is nothing but Sat. I cannot know it through my eyes, but I can know it through Vedanta Pramana. So, truth is Vedanta Pramana Gamyam, Anya Pramana Agamyam. I cannot know the truth through other means. Therefore, Vedanta is the right way of knowing the truth. Up to this we saw. Now, to explain this and also the spiritual journey of a seeker, teacher is giving an example, a story. Okay? So let us see. Section 14, page number 87. यथा सौम्य पुरुषम् गंधारेभ्यः अभिनद्धाक्षम् आनीय तं ततो अतिजने विसृजेत् स यथा तत्र प्राङ्वा उदङ्वा अदराङ्वा प्रत्यङ्वा प्रद्मायीत अभिनद्दाक्ष आनीतः अभिनद्दाक्षो विसृष्टः सो नाउ देयर इज ए स्टोरी ए स्मॉल एपिसोड दैट हैपेंड व्हाट इज हैपनिंग देयर वाज वन फेलो. He lived in Gandhar area. Gandhar is modern Kandahar. Kandahar is where? Afghanistan. So, there he used to live. And he was kidnapped from there. Even in those days, this was happening. Something to do with that place, I am sure. So somebody was taken away. And how? Abhinaddaksham. Abhinaddaksham means with blindfold and hands and all tied, he was kidnapped from there. Whatever he had, they took away. And then, tataha atijane visraje. They left him in that place where there was nobody. So in forest they left him, in some mountains and all. They say, you stay here now. then what does it do? Saha yatha tatra prangva udangva adarangva pratyangva. So in the eastern direction, northern direction, southern direction, western direction, he is going to shout. So they probably forgot to remove the, or forgot to put the band on his mouth. Or somehow he must have removed, like he tried this way, that way, something he must have done. And he started shouting. Pradhmaita means to shout. Dhma, to shout. Pradhmaita abhinaddhaksha anitaha. They have brought me here with blindfold. Abhinaddhaksha visrishtaha. And they have tied me here. They have left me here. Means hell, hell, shouting. Okay. Then what happened? Let us see further mantra. Tasya yatha,
tasya yatha,
abhinahanam,
abhinahanam,
pramuchya,
pramuchya,
prabruyat,
prabruyat,
etam disham gandharaha,
etam disham gandharaha,
etam disham vraja iti,
etam disham vraja iti.
Saha,
saha,
gramat gramam prachan,
gramat gramam prachan,
pandito medhavi,
pandito medhavi,
gandharan eva,
gandharan eva,
upasampadyeta,
upasampadyeta,
eva meva iha,
eva meva iha,
acharyavan purusho veda,
acharyavan purusho veda,
tasya tavadeva chiram,
tasya tavadeva chiram,
Yavannavi mokshye,
Yavannavi mokshye,
atha sampatsye,
atha sampatsye,
iti,
iti,
sampatsye, it will become, because of sandhi. Okay, so now, he was shouting, help, help, I am left here, alone. So at that time, somebody heard, and that person was very compassionate, very loving. He said, how long this fellow is going to roam around here in wild forest with blindfold? So he goes to him and releases his bandhana. So first is, you know, they release the blindfold. So the moment you see someone in front of you, relaxed, solution is there. And then he says, etam disham gandhara, in this direction you go. And he gives some landmarks. You go this way, you will walk a little, then you will see a small stream of water, then you go in right direction, left direction, some things. And then, if you go on walking, a mountain-like thing will come, you will have to go over it, then your city will come. Etam disham gandharaha, etam disham vrajayati. Go in this direction and take these landmarks. So now, saha, gramat gramam prachan. He goes from village to village. Means place to place. He goes this way. Whatever that the person told him how to go, he remembers. Gramat gramam prachan. And therefore how he should be panditaha and medhavi. Medha means ability to retain the instructions. So he remembered, he did not have the other GPS I like, you know, walking with the iPhone. It goes with the direction. No, not like that. He didn't have that. Gramat gramam prachan. But he remembered everything in his huge hard drive here. And Panditaha means he also knew how to think if some landmarks were not very clear, very evident. So if they might have said, you know, some stream will come, and let's say the stream is dried at that time. So you said I have to look for something, go on walking. Not like that. Means he was intelligent enough to use his own viveka also. He remembered what was instructed, and he also used his viveka shakti to deliberate properly. The one who taught, the one who gave instruction, he left. He was not there all the time. And this fellow, gramat gramam prachan, pandito medhavi, gandharan eva upasampadyeta. He will reach his village, his destination. Up to this is the story. Now, I am sure we must have understood what this story means. Who is the one who is kidnapped? We are kidnapped here. What is the blindfold? Ignorance, avidya, and moha, infatuation, erroneous way of thinking. And the way we are tied down to our own body, our own attachments to near and dear ones, that we are not able to see the truth. And we are shouting everywhere, help, help. Then who comes? Some extremely compassionate person. Paramakarunika. So, how he releases, what is this bondage? This is written beautifully by Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji in the Bhashya of this Upanishad. So this part I am going to elaborate. Okay? All you have to do is just listen. Evam. Okay, I'm going to read this and explain. You will know how beautifully Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji touches our feelings. He gives words to where we are. What is our dilemma in this world? Evam vikroshataha tasya yatha abhinahanam. Yatha bandhanam. Abhinahanam is the bandhanam, bondage. Vikroshataha, agitated and shouting, screaming. Yatha bandhanam pramuchya, having released first, that become free from here. Muktva karunikaha kashchit, some compassionate one. Etam disham uttarataha gandharaha. Etam disham vrajayati. Go in this direction, in this northern way, if you travel, you will reach Gandhara. Iti prabruyat. Saha evam karunikena bandhanat mokshitaha, released from bondage. Gramat gramantaram prachan panditaha. Panditaha, the one to whom upadesha is given. Upadeshavan. Medhavi. And who is Medhavi? Para upadishta grama pravesha marga avadharana samartha. Sanskrit is very simple. Para Upadeshta, taught by someone, Grama Pravesha Marga, the path to enter to his village, Avadharana Samartha, he was capable of deliberating and remembering. Son, Gandharan eva upasampadyeta. He will reach Gandhara. Na itaraha, not the other fellow. Who is the other fellow? Moodamatihi. So, Bhagavan Bhashyakar suddenly remembered Bhajagovindam, his own composition. Moodamate. And you know, this is out of compassion. He says, fool, why can't you get it? No, I want to make it 10-year program, 20-year program. Okay, take your time. Na Moodamati. Who is Moodamati? Deshantara Darshana Trit. Va means either a person who does not know how to think, he will not attain. Or the individual who is desirous of seeing other things. So he has to go to his place and suddenly on the way he sees some drama going on somewhere. Oh, let's go there. Otherwise something else is going on. Oh, let's go here. This is Deshantara Darshana Trit. He will not attain. So the one who wants to attain should be very clear. Chandogya Upanishad talks are going on, I am there. No other these, that, other activities. Everything, whole world can wait. Priorities are very clear. In the same way, now, applying the Vedanta part. Sva vishayebhyah gandharebhyah purushah taskaraihi abhinadhakshah. The one who is bound by who? The Vishayas, O-E-T. Okay. This is OET. Okay? These are the dacoits. Taskara means looters. They tie us down. Taskaraihi abhinadhakshaha avivekaha. And this fellow does not have viveka, discrimination, that my goal is to attain my true nature. He is lost in vishayas. House, car, the Bhagavan Bhashyakar is going to elaborate everything. Avivekaha, dingmudaha, lost in direction of life. What is my purpose? What am I supposed to accomplish here? Confused. Dingmudaha. Ashanaya pipasadiman, hungry and thirsty all the time. Meal one, meal two, meal three, meal four. Ashanaya pipasadiman. But here ashana pipasa means the one who has to constantly worry about where will I get my next food from, or when I retire. Generally people don't worry about every meal, but their idea is, if I retire at 65 and if I live up to 95, will social security be there or not? Or should I keep working and keep accumulating? So he is worried about yoga kshema. This is where Bhagavan said, you don't worry about yoga kshema. You think of me, I will take care of your yoga kshema. Yoga kshemam vahamyaham. I will take care. You don't worry. You focus on the truth. But ashanaya pipasadiman, Vyagra Taskaradi Anek Bhaya Anartha Vrata Yutam Aranyam Praveshita. He is in this forest. And what is there in forest? Tiger. Other robbers. Already he is robbed. Now others will come and they will say, do you have any money? No. Then what are you doing here? They will give him 2-3. This is what they do. That's why you have to keep some cash when somebody comes. I am not joking. So then, because their purpose is not to bother you, they want money. You give them some money, they'll let you go. But if you don't have money, then they will be unhappy because you are not able to fulfill their desires. So, Vyagra, Taskaradi, Anek, Bhaya, Anartha, Vratam, Vrata, Yutam, Aranya. Filled with all these fearful, frightening entities, frightening elements in forest. Aranyam Praveshitaha, Dukhardaha. Internally weeping, vikroshan. Vikroshan means agitation or anger. Bandhane bhyaha mumukshuhu. Now he wants to become free from this bandhana. That's why he is called mumukshu. So a mumukshu is the one who is seriously thinking about this. Bandhane vyaha mumukshuhu tishthati. He stays there, means he is thinking now. And then at that time, saha kathanchit eva karunikena kenachit mokshitaha. So, released by some compassionate one. Kenachit mokshitaha, released by that person. Swadeshan Gandharan eva apanna. Then he attains Gandhara. Simile is not over. Huh? He is going to continue. Bhagavan Bhashyakar, when he gets opportunity to write, some of these are his favorite topics. Because he can touch our heart. So, he reaches Gandhara, Swadeshan Gandharan eva apannaha nirvrutaha sukhi abhut. Nirvrutaha means he is now peaceful, he is relaxed. So, even if you are in forest, you feel, let's say, extremely sleepy. Can you sleep in forest? Because you are worried some tiger will come and eat you. So, only when you reach home, then you say, then for 2 days this fellow will not wake up. So, we are restless when we are in this world, truly speaking. Sukhi abhut, evam eva sataha, in this way, jagat atma swarupa, swarupa tejo vannadimayam deha aranyam. What is the forest? This forest is teja ab annam, in the form of the body. This is the forest. In this forest and in this forest, jagat and deha, both are covered. So one idea is, I am in this world, and the other is, I am in this body. If I think I am body, then I am in this world. If I think I am perceiver, feeler, thinker, I am in the body. Jagat atma swarupat tejo bannadimayam deharanyam. Vata, pitta, kapha, rudhira, meda, mamsa, asthi, majja, shukra, krimi, mutra, purishavat. If you did not know what is this body, here comes a list. No, no, my body is very good. Wonderful. Okay, let me tell you. Bhagavan Vashikari. Water. A lot of air is inside. Yes, I think I know that. Pitta. Lot of... what is the English word for pitta?
Bile.
Bile.
Bile. Yellow, yellow thing. Pitta. Kapha. Which can be white, yellow, green, anything. We should enjoy this. This is our... This is where we are all the time indulging, enjoying. But when somebody talks about it, oh, don't talk about it. Vata, pitta, kapha. Rudhira, blood. Then, meda. Fat. Meda means... We all know all these things very well. And wherever we have to look for it. Meda. Medo, mamsa. Mamsa means?
Flesh.
Asti, bones. Majja, marrow, means bone marrow. Shukra. Shukra means virya, semen. So the essence of this food that we consume, which is gathered, that shukra. Krimi, worms in the body, parasites. They say this is our territory. We are the host here. What are you doing here? And then if you don't eat, they will... And you know, these are, they say, good bacteria. Right? So if you don't have, you have to have probiotic. Then to kill them, you have antibiotic. And it just goes on. They say, we are going to be there. As long as this body is there, and even after this body goes for a few hours, we will continue here. Nourishment comes for them. Then, mutra. Unless the urine is removed, it is carried. What else? And purisha means the stool also. That is also carried. Where? In this forest. This nice forest that move around everywhere. In Vivek Chudamani, this is called moving toilet. This body is this only. Don't give this description when somebody is eating food. That fellow's appetite will go completely. But this is to understand how we indulge these bodies. We think, this body is so wonderful. Then, Shita Ushna Adi Aneka Dvandva Dukkha Vachcha. And various sorrows in the form of heat, cold, all other experiences of duality. Dvandva Dukkha Vachcha. Idam Moha Patta Abhinaddhaksha. Now he is blindfolded with the fold of Moha. Thick one. Okay. And what are the ropes? Bharya. For man, it is wife. For wife, it is husband. So don't look at the person next to you and start thinking, you are responsible for everything. No. You made that choice. It is the karma, remember. That same person can also be helpful in spiritual journey if they walk with you. So not to look at only in negative way. Parasparam bhavayantaha shreya paramavasyata. You help each other mutually, you will attain the truth. Bharya, putra. Putra means putri is also included. Huh? Don't say only putra. Bharya, putra, mitra. These are the soft attachments. They don't really bind you. They say you go if you want to go. Who is stopping you? Take sannyasa now. Who will take? Right? No, I want to take care of you. Bharya, putra, mitra, pashu. Cattle also and pets also. You know, without my dog, how can I go for Brahma Jnanam? What is wrong with that? Anyway, don't put all this on the internet. Bharya, putra, mitra, pashu, bandhu adi, other friends, relatives. So they will also, the day you say, I am going to ashram, he said, what is wrong with you? Don't go. Stay here. We will make this room as ashram. They will give you all these options. We'll put some trees inside. We will paint it like stones. Then you don't have to come out for food also. We will pass it, but stay here. And we will give you Wi-Fi. Then what will happen? You are in the world. Mahatmaji, you don't need all these things anywhere. Putra, mitra, pashu, bandhuadi, drishta, adrishta, aneka vishaya, trishna, pashitaha. And the desires, they are also binding him, the vasanas. So there are some seen fetters, shackles, and there are some unseen ones. So only when the situation comes, those vasanas will express. And people say, up till now everything was okay, now what happened? That vasana has expressed now. Trishna Pashitaha. Then who are the robbers, the looters? Punya, apunya di taskaraihi. Papa and punya. They have forced me to take birth. You see the power of the language? What we otherwise would not think, it brings it out. Punya, apunya adi taskaraihi praveshitaha. They led me into this, in this body and in this world. And the ideas that are entertained by this fellow, aham amushya putraha. I am son of so and so. Means I am this jati, niti, kula, gotra, all these. I am born in this nakshatra. First thing they will ask you is this, what is your rashi, what is your nakshatra? And your name, father's name, grandfather's name, tell everything. He said, this is ajnanam. You are birthless. Aham amushya putraha. Mama ete bandhavaha. All these are my relatives. I am not elaborating too much, otherwise you will be unhappy with me. Sukhi aham, I am so happy here. Dukhi aham, I am so unhappy. Mudaha panditaha, I am confused. Everything is clear to me, Swamiji. My life is very clean. Panditaha. Dharmikaha, I am very religious person. All these are ignorant ideas. If you didn't know, this whole list is of ignorant ideas where there is superimposition of either body or mind or intellect and their dharmas. Dharmi adhyasa and dharma adhyasa. superimposition of the entities and their attributes. Dharmikaha, Bandhuman, I have so many contacts here. Just use my, here is my card. You are Brahman. And we think, oh, no. I am this fellow. Jataha, Mridaha, I am born. I will die one day. Jirnaha, I am becoming weaker now. I am losing my strength. Jirna. Papi. He has taken a lot of pap. So he is papi. Putro mein mrtaha. Then one day he'll say, oh, my son is. Son is dead or my son is not listening to me. He's crying. Dhanam mein nashtam. My wealth is all gone. Ha hatosmi katham jivishyami kame gatihi kimme tranam. Oh, I am shattered in this life. How am I going to live? What is going to happen to me? Who will protect me? This is all that is going on in his mind. And remember, before studying Vedanta, if these are the thoughts, it is okay. After studying Vedanta, if I am in the same boat, so as I told you in the morning, I have not developed that darshan yet. Iti evam aneka shata sahasra anartha jalavan vikroshan. Hundreds of thousands of such erroneous ideas he entertains about himself and the world. Kathanchit eva punya atishayat. Somehow, when his merits have come to great number, then what happens? Paramakarunikam, extremely compassionate teacher comes in his life. Paramakarunikam kanchit, sat brahma atmavidam, the one who knows Brahman, which in this chapter is known as sat. Sat brahma atmavidam, I am that Brahman, the one who knows this, such compassionate person. Vimukta bandhanam, the one who is free from all such bondages, wrong ideas. Brahmishtham, established in Brahman. Established in Brahman means established in Brahma Jnana. He does not take himself to be anything other than Brahma. Yada asadayati, when such an individual comes to him, tena cha Brahma vida karunyat darshita samsara vishaya dosha darshana marga. That knower of Brahman, out of compassion, he shows the defects in this world. What are you doing here? There is no end to miseries in this world. So, darshita samsara vishaya dosha darshana marga virakta samsara vishaya vya. And this person, now when the teacher shows this, so then what happens? The individual himself realizes the defects in this world. This is, what am I doing? And look at people. I thought in Los Angeles I am going to have fun. All the time I will enjoy life. Hollywood is right here. Always I will go around in convertible cars, drive here and there. But old age will come, sorrows will come. Before us also people lived here. How much they could enjoy? Didn't they have old age, disease, death, all the problems? problems of union and separation. So when I realize, then I say I have to work for some real solution. I cannot go on living like this. Then viraktaha samsar vishayabhya, he says, give me something else. I'm not interested in these things. Then to that person, the teacher, what does he say? Na asitvam samsari, amushya putradi dharmavan. You are not a samsari, son of so and so. Means you are not born, you are not body. Kim tarhi, then who am I? Sat yat tattvam asi. Are you are that truth. What did teacher say? Svetaketu, to Svetaketu. Saya esho anima, aitadatma vidagam sarvam, tat satyam sa atma, tat tvamasi Svetaketu. That you are, means you are not this body, mind, intellect. You are Brahman. You are not this Swami. This name that we are given is only for worldly transactions. This identity is not my real identity. Na asitvam samsari amushya putratvadi dharmavan kim tarhi yat sat yat tattvamasi iti avidya moha pata abhinahana abhinahanat mokshitah. The blindfold which is avidya and moha. Now Bhagavan puts both. Ignorance and superimposition. Avidya and moha. These are all technical words. Okay, why each word matters, when you study, then you know. Gurudev used to put these two as non-apprehension and misapprehension. Avidya and moha. Avidya moha pata abhinahanat mokshitaha gandhar purusha vachya swam sadatmanam upasampadya sukhi nirvrutaha syam iti evam eva artham aha. Acharyavan purusho veda. So this is how the one who has teacher in his life will know the truth. Acharyavan purusho veda means this. Now, Acharyavan, this word is also very beautiful. Acharyavan means not only the one who has Acharya, the one who has accepted authority of Acharya in his life or her life. That is called Acharyavan. Having a person by itself in life is not enough. That I take their instructions, their teachings as my guidebook. I call GPS as Guru Parampara and Shastra. Not only Guru Parampara, not only Shastra. You have to put the two together. Guru Parampara and Shastra is our GPS. Because Guru will speak of Shastra and Shastra will say go to Guru. See here, Shruti is Pramana. Shruti says Acharya is Pramana. Acharyavan Purusha Veda. And Acharya will speak from Shruti only. Combo. They have teamed up. Actually, that is a winning team. Shastra Acharya together. Acharyavan Purusha Veda. Okay, this much Bhashya. I hope you got some joy out of this. You know, if you skip one meal, it is okay. But this we should not skip. This is our food. That's why Bhagavan Shankaracharya ji, when he goes to Mandan Mishra ji, he says, I have come here, so Mandan Mishra ji, I will give you bhiksha. He says, no, I don't want food bhiksha, I want vad bhiksha. I want to have debate with you. Because they are thinkers. They are not only eaters. Evameva iha acharyavan purusho veda. In that way, the one who has teacher, guide and shastra in their life, they will know the truth. Truth means they will attain sat. Like how this fellow attained Gandhara. Gandharan eva upasampadyeta evameva iha acharyavan purusho veda. Then tasya, actually you underline, if you want to underline this acharyavan purusho veda, double. And tasya tavadeva chiram yavanna vimokshe atha sampatsye, this also you underline. That is the next part of the second mantra, the last line. And what does that say? That part says, this knower of truth has to wait only this long until his prarabdha is over. Okay. So now on this also there is a big debate. Now I will tell you in brief. Bhashya is wonderful, you know. So if somebody knows the truth, somebody attains realization, he should be free. What should be the nature of realization? I am free from karma. This Atma is free from all the karmas performed by perceiver, feeler, thinker. Correct? Yes?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. So, this Atma is free from all the karmas. What are the three types of karmas? Sanchita, Agami, Prarabdha. Right? You know this. So he should be free from all karmas. If he is free from Prarabdha karma, which has given this body, then what will happen? He will die immediately. The moment realization takes place, in class itself, in the hall, gone. Realization will bring end to prarabdha. Then he should die. If this happens, then what will happen? All those who are realized will die. So then, first of all, would anyone pursue this knowledge? If you are told that the result of this knowledge is death, then people say, Swamiji, you go on giving pravachan. We are not coming. This is one problem. Second problem is, all those who know the truth, means all jnanis, if they die, then those who are remaining are what? Ajnani. Then those who are teaching will be Ajnani. So Ajnani will teach what? Jnanam or Ajnanam?
Ajnani.
So they will continue the parampara of Ajnanis. Not Jnanis parampara. They will continue Ajnanis parampara. Therefore, it is said, prarabdha will continue. But they can impart knowledge to others. This is the brief idea, otherwise there is elaborate discussion. But what this means is, he will be jivan mukta, and then once the body drops, when the prarabdha karmas are over, then he will be called videha mukta. But really speaking, he is, from his own standpoint, he is not jivan mukta, he is not videha mukta. He is nitya mukta, nitya shuddha buddha mukta. He is ever free. What jivan and videha? This is from worldly standpoint, he is jivan mukta and videha. Okay? So this is understood, this section. Now let us see whether Svetaketu got it or not. Saya esho anima.
Saya esho anima.
Aitadatmyamidam sarvam.
Aitadatmyamidam sarvam.
tat satyam,
tat satyam,
sa atma,
sa atma,
tattvamasi svetaketu,
tattvamasi svetaketu,
iti,
iti,
bhuya eva ma bhagavan,
bhuya eva ma bhagavan,
vijñāpayat kriti,
vijñāpayat kriti,
tatha somyeti ho vacha,
tatha somyeti ho vacha.
Svetaketu said, I didn't get it. Or he got it, but he said, this is the opportunity. Don't let the teacher go. Ask more. Until teacher himself is tired. Ask. Because such opportunity, I will not get again. And you know, teacher has to be in that inspired mood. Then, patapat, everything comes. He says, no, I didn't get it. Or, can you please teach me again? He doesn't say, I didn't get it. Can you please teach me again? Again means differently. So, the purpose of this section is that the truth can be known if I am Acharyavan, I am Panditaha Medhavi. So, Pandita Medhavi means Sadhana Chatushtaya Sampanna. And Acharyavan means Shruti and Upanishad, both are with me. Then I will get it. Okay, so now teacher explains further. Section 15, page number 92. Now if you remember, earlier in section 8, mantra number 6, there was a sequence given for somebody who had departed. So somebody who is departing, how the person dies. You remember?
Yes.
And I had told you the death of Jnani and death of Ajnani. Both are talked about here. So that was death of Ajnani. Now in this section we are talking about death of Jnani.
Purusham somya,
uta upatapinam,
uta upatapinam,
nyatayah,
nyatayah,
paryupasate,
paryupasate,
jana simam, jana simam,
jana simam, jana simam,
iti,
iti,
tasya,
tasya,
yavanna vang manasi sampadyate,
yavanna vang manasi sampadyate,
mana prane,
mana prane,
pranastejasi,
pranastejasi,
tejaparasyam devatayam,
tejaparasyam devatayam,
tavajjanati,
tavajjanati.
So, now this person is on deathbed. Jnani. Upatapinam. Upatapinam means somebody who has fever now, high fever. So now, doctors were called. Doctor said, don't call me, call all family members. Because now, time is running out. Take all the pictures, final text message, whatever that he has to send. Ask him to send, because this ID will no longer be used anymore. I think modern doctors will have to tell all these things only. Because this fellow, wait, let me put my thing on Facebook. Take one selfie, put it on Facebook just because before going. Bye to everyone. Upatapinam jnatayah. Jnatayah means all the relatives, jnatijanas, paryupasate. They all have come. So somebody flying from here, there, everywhere, all over the world have come there. Now when these people come, what do? They will first ask, you know, the other, how is old man? What is the status? So they say, he's breathing. Okay. Can he recognize people? Some people he recognizes. Some memory loss is there. See, all these things happen. What do they call? Dementia.
Dementia.
So then, this fellow goes, how are you? He will shout there. answer will be. okay, everything is. Do you remember me? That is given. Janasi Maam? Don't shout, I know. You are the one who gave me maximum headache. That fellow who is going to depart, this is what he, but he may not be able to say. Do you remember? You are my third sons, second wives, fourth. Yes. I know you. Janasi Maam means people who gather there, they want to know. Okay. Then slowly all faculties go. Iti tasya yavan na, yavat na, this is common, this will you have to carry forward. Yavat na vang manasi sampadyate tavat janati. Until the speech has not entered into mind, until that point he will recognize. Until mana prane na sampadyate tavat janati. Until mind has not entered into prana, he will recognize something. Prana tejasi yavat na sampadyate tavat janati. So pranas, until they have not entered into fire. So this is the sequence, you remember in 8th section, 6th mantra I had told you. And teja parasyam devatayam yavat na sampadyate tavat janati. Means teja has to merge in sat. Vak, speech has to merge in mind. Mind has to merge in prana. Prana into fire. Fire into sat. So then slowly body will become cold. First the speech will go, then all the perception, etc., means even thinking, recognizing will go, then breathing will stop, body will become cold, they will declare, he is gone. And when this happens, then what happens? Second mantra. Atha yada asya vang manasi sampadyate manaprane pranas tejasi teja parasyam devatayam atha na janati. When this happens, each faculty shuts down and everything merges into sat. Then he doesn't recognize anything. He doesn't know anything because he is gone. So this is jnani. Then the question is, jnani also has gone in the same way as ajnani. Ajnani's departure and jnani's departure have no visual difference. Then somebody may think, if Ajnani also goes in the same way, Jnani also goes in the same way, then what is the use of attending your classes? Because everything is same. So we'll come to that. Okay? Let us see next mantra now. Saya esho anima.
Saya esho anima.
Aitadatma vidagam sarvam.
Aitadatma vidagam sarvam.
Tat satyam sa atma.
Tat satyam sa atma.
Tat tvamasi svetaketo.
Tat tvamasi svetaketo.
Iti.
Iti.
Bhuya eva ma bhagavan.
Bhuya eva ma bhagavan.
Vignyapayatviti.
Vignyapayatviti.
Tatha somyeti ho vacha.
Tatha somyeti ho vacha.
So, teacher said, this is that sat where jnani after death merges. And this is that sat where ajnani also merges. But ajnani will come back from this sat. Jnani will not come back. That sat, you are. O Svetaketu. Svetaketu said, Bhuya eva ma bhagavan vignyapayatu. can you please teach me more? So now what he wants to know is, what is the difference between Jnani's death and Ajnani's death? What difference it makes if I have knowledge or I don't have knowledge? And that is the next section. But in essence, we should understand that Jnani will not come back. Ajnani will come back. This is the essence. Now, elaboration is the next section. This is another story. Okay? Section 16, page number 95. Teacher also comes out with wonderful ideas. Purusham somya,
purusham somya,
uta,
uta,
hastagrihitam,
hastagrihitam,
anayanti,
anayanti,
apaharshit,
apaharshit,
steyam akarshit,
steyam akarshit,
parashum asmai,
parashum asmai, tapata iti,
sayadi tasya karta bhavati,
sayadi tasya karta bhavati,
tataha,
tataha,
eva,
eva,
anutam
atmanam kurute,
saha,
saha,
amrita abhisandaha,
amrita abhisandaha,
anrutena,
anrutena,
atmanam antardhaya,
atmanam antardhaya,
parashum taptam,
parashum taptam,
pratigrinhati,
pratigrinhati,
sahadahyate,
sahadahyate,
athahanyate,
athahanyate.
So, this is another, this is very beautiful. This Gandhara story is very beautiful, and this one also. So there is a king sitting in a court, and assembly is there, all the ministers, other wise people, they all are sitting. At that time, some security people, they bring general, army general or some general of security is also sitting there. The security fellows, they bring one person tied, hastagrihitam. Anayanti, anayanti, they bring him in the court. And they say, he has committed a theft. Steyam akarshi. Apaharshi. He has committed a crime. He has committed theft. So the king looks at him. What? Did you do this? What will be his response? No, I have not done anything. And you, king will look at the security people. Yes, he has done it. So now there is dispute. Then only he has to come to court, right? If there is no dispute, they need not bring him to court. He accepts, then punish him and over. But here there is dispute. So, decision is now with king. Okay, let us do test whether he has stolen anything or not. So, what is the test? In those days, he say, way of presenting, okay? Don't take it literally. So the test is, prepare one hot iron axe. Means iron axe, put it in fire and heat it up and keep it there. Then ask this fellow to touch that. Hold it. Parashum asmai tapata iti. Bring hot axe. Iron axe for him. And taptam parashum pratigrinhati, when he holds on to this, and if he is speaker of untruth, means if he is a liar, he has committed the crime, he has committed the theft, and he says, no, I have not done anything. then when he holds on to this hot iron, he'll get burnt. So first is, he will prove himself wrong. Correct? Because he is speaking untruth. So because he is speaking untruth, he will prove himself wrong. He'll get burnt. And now, king will punish additionally. Right? Because he has committed the crime, so king will say, give him 100. Put him in the prison. So if he is speaker of truth, if he is speaker of untruth, he will prove himself wrong. Then he'll get burned. Then he'll get punished by king. Okay? Next mantra. Mystery. All this is, you know, you may wonder, what, Swamiji, we come here to study what is Sat, Brahman. You are telling I and this, that, okay? Atha yadi. Tasya akarta bhavati. Tata eva. Satyam atmanam kurute. Sa satya abhisandha. Satyena.
Atmanam.
Antardhaya.
Parashum taptam.
Pratigrinhati. Sa nadahyate. Atha muchyate. On the other hand, if he is not a doer of this crime, means he did not commit this theft or crime, whatever he is accused of, tataha satyam atmanam kurute, then he will prove himself true. Right? That he did not do it. Then he will not get burnt. Then king will say, release him. And king will declare, with all honor he should go, because all charges are false. And he may file a lawsuit against the local people that why did you guys accuse me, so he might get some money also out of it. So he will prove himself innocent, not subject to any crime, any theft. Okay? Now, what is the meaning of this story? This is the most important thing now. Let us read one line. Sa yatha tatra. Na adahyet. That's it. After that is aitadatma vidagam sarvam, etc. So, just as he does not get burnt, that's all. Now, what does this mean? Pay attention now. This hot iron axe is this world. The hot iron axe is this world. And what are we doing? We are in contact with this world. And when we are in contact with this world, then what does this world do? It burns us. Now it will burn only that person who is holding on to untruth. The one who is speaking untruth means the one who is holding on to untruth, that fellow will get burnt. The one who is holding on to truth will not get burnt. Now, what is the untruth? Untruth is, I am body, I am jiva. This is untruth. Holding on to this notion that I am this body, I am a jiva, this will burn me. Whereas, holding on to truth, and what is that? I am Brahma, Sat. Aham Brahma Asmi. With this understanding, if I live in this world, then this world will not burn me. Then the one who gets burned because he is holding on to untruth, he is punished, he is bound, he is imprisoned. Whereas the one who is holding on to truth, that I am Brahman, then he is not burned, he is released, he is liberated. So what is the difference between jnani and ajnani? Jnani is liberated because he is holding on to the truth, aham brahmasmi. And ajnani is bound, he gets burned and he is imprisoned. What is the prison? Samsara. Punarapi jananam, punarapi maranam. This is prison. So he will come back. So in this world, when I live, I should live with this wisdom. I am Brahman. Then even though the departure of jnani and ajnani looks similar, va manasi sampadyate manaprane pranatyajasi teja parasyam devatayam, that is similar. But one will go to not come back and the other will go to come back. So yadgatva nanivartante, Bhagavan said in 15th chapter. Taddhama paramam. That sat in which, having merged, the jnani does not come back. Means, jnani knows that I am that sat, therefore he is jnani. Then his gross body will die at the end of the prarabdha karma. So gross body will end, subtle body will also disintegrate in 5 subtle elements. For ajnani, only gross body will disintegrate. Subtle body will continue. So it will take another gross body, then another gross body, until subtle body disintegrates. Okay. Now let's see what happened to Svetaketu. Aitadatmyam idam sarvam. Tat satyam,
tat satyam,
sa
atma,
tattvamasi Svetaketo iti, tadha asya, vijagnyau iti, vijagnyau iti,
vijagnyau iti, vijagnyau iti.
Svetaketu did not say, bhuya eva ma bhagavan vijnapayatu. When this time father said, you are that, O Svetaketu. Got it. Vijagnyau iti. Got it? You got it. Svetaketu, Swamiji, I understood the whole purpose of this. Svetaketu realized. We are not studying for Svetaketu's realization. So, how beautifully through this last section, the jnani's departure is also explained. So what is the essence of this? I should live in this world holding on to truth. I am Brahman and Brahman alone and nothing else. If I live in this world with the idea that I am body or I am jiva, be ready to cry. Then don't complain. So Upanishad is very clear. If I live with erroneous notions, I will get burned, I will cry, and I will come back. I will be in the prison. if I live here with this understanding, I am Brahman, then I am free. Okay? With this, we conclude our Jnana Yajna. So, Svetaketu got it. And with God's grace, Guru Parampara's blessings and the Shastra's blessings, we understand we also are that Supreme Truth. Okay, so we'll do the Shanti Mantra. First, Apyayantu Mamangani, then Purnamada. Okay, then whatever announcements and all that will happen. Om Apyayantu Mamangani, Vak Pranas Chakshu Shrotramato, Balamindriyani Chasarvani, Sarvam Brahma Upanishadam. Maham Brahma Nirakuryam, Maham Brahma Nirakarod, Anirakaranam Asva Nirakaranam Ne Asuru, Tadatmani Nirateya Upanishat Sudharmaha, Emai Santu, Om Shanti Shanti Shanti, Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat, Purnamudachyate, Purnasya, Purnamadaya, Purnameva Vashishyate.